This is The Splendid Table from APM, American Public Media, the show for people who love to eat. I'm Lynn Rossetto Casper.
For more than 20 years, anyone with an appetite for food and the culture surrounding it has had a standing reservation on Saturdays for The Splendid Table. Well, after 22 seasons, the host with a voice as rich as butter is retiring, and lucky for us, Lynn Rossetto Casper has braved Twin Cities traffic to our humble kitchen today. Welcome.
I'll tell you, it pays to be trained as a Formula One driver right now in our cities. You know, you take those curves. Yes, but thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
This has been such an exceptional run. This show could have been a recipe show where you had call-ins, but by design, that isn't the way
you
imagined it.
The show actually evolved from a concept I had, and it was shared by Sally Swift, who's our managing producer. But really, we're attached at the hip, and we created the show together. And this was in 1993 or 4 that we had the idea. I had written a book that looked at a region in Italy and its food, and what I had realized for a long time before that, I taught cooking for a long time, you can't separate the dish from the people or the place, the idea, and especially when you're looking at traditional recipes, the history and the stories and the folklore. I mean, it's fascinating. So it was 10 years of researching, and finally I realized I better put this stuff together between covers. And Sally was someone who got this. Mm. She called me and said, have you thought of doing a radio show? I had been on NPR. And I thought, oh, this is gonna be another person who's saying, let's do recipes, and I wanna tell stories too.
Talk about those stories. What have been stories, and I know there are many.
Oh, golly. I guess, one story, I've told this a lot of times before, but it's the kind of thing you probably know very well. Anyone who's in media knows about the surprise. In the beginning, it was a call-in show, and we would have a guest. Well, it's always been a call-in show, but I mean, the whole show was call-in. And we would have one guest, and I would interview them, and then people would ask them questions. And we had a master organic gardener on, who I'm embarrassed to say, I don't remember his name. He was from the East. And he was a wonderful guest, and he was great with people. You know, everything was working. But Sally, who lived out in Marin and had a great garden, had said, if you don't ask him how to get rid of deer without hurting them, because every time she planted, the deer ate it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm not going to let you off the air. So that's what I said to him. I said, okay, how do you get rid of those, you know, Bambi without hurting Bambi? And without thinking twice, he said, well, you put cinder blocks around your garden and then you pee on them. And you know, silence on air is really, you know what it's like. A minute of silence is like 18 hours, you know, of disaster. I'm never speechless. and in my ear, Sally, and she said, well, you know, maybe her husband, or if she has a son, wants to do it. Yeah. And in my ear, she's saying, fat chance.
<I'm> just... Lynn, this show has been on the air during the explosion of celebrity chefs and Food Network type shows and all of that. It's made all of us more interested. How's that impacted what you've done on the air?
Oh, I think, well, first of all, we've talked to most of those people.
Yeah.
You know, this is the thing about this kind of work, is that you are really privileged. We talk to all kinds of people, and every time you talk to someone, you've done research, and you learn from people. But let's see, we've had Julia Child, of course. Julia has been
a great
friend of the show, and I had known her for a very long time. Nora Ephron, wonderful guest, funny, et cetera, and had great tips. Like, for instance, never entertain at a rectangular table. Right now, everyone that's listening is saying, oh my God, what am I gonna do? The reality is you want people to be able to look at each other. And an oval table takes up just as much room, but you can all see
each other.
Right, and you can stuff more people in. And she used to say every time she was invited to a dinner party and there was a long table, she thought, okay, that's it. I'm gonna talk to this person, and if I'm lucky, that person, and that's it. I wanna know everybody. Let's see now, Michael Pollan. We've had Michael Pollan on many times. Alice Waters, her first project with school gardens.
Sure, San Francisco's Alice Waters.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. And she started with a school in Oakland that didn't even have hot water.
Mm.
And this garden, it was a from a neighborhood that had, you know, represented from every culture you can imagine. And they had started the garden, and they were building the all aspects of the garden into the curriculum, which was fabulous. I guess for me, there's a lot of people people haven't heard of, but and I'm embarrassed, I don't remember his name. The gentleman at the U of M who developed the Honeycrisp apple was a wonderful guest because, first of all, he brought in apples for us to taste, apples that were sort of in the testing phase.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that it takes 30 years to develop an apple, and many horticulturalists will develop an apple and never live to see it actually, you know, refined and go to market?
And it changed the whole game.
It did. And that, yeah,
the
taste.
Honeycrisp,
he said at last,
pay for it.
At last people will you know, farmers wanted taste, not just pretty.
Our time, unfortunately, is over here now. We're going to wish you the very, very best.
Thank
this
you.
Isn't the end of that. What's next for you is you're going to enjoy your life and do travel and cook, and you're going to have a wonderful celebration of your career. And I want to tell people about that.
Sure.
There are a limited number of tickets left for this. Lynn Rosetto Casper is going to be feted at the Splendid Table live event at the Fitzgerald Theater on Thursday, October 12th. A limited number, as mentioned, are left. For more info, head to care11.com and the news at 4:00.